What's up everyone, Takedown here, back with another conspiracy video. Today's actually hits close to home for me because it is on one of my favorite musicians of all time. Today marks 25 years since the death of Kurt Cobain. His death has officially been ruled suicide, but there are many people that believe it was in fact a murder. So today I'm going to be looking at some of the evidence myself. Let's get right into this. Kurt Cobain was the lead singer, guitarist, and songwriter for Nirvana. Officially ruled, he shot himself dead on April 5th, 1994. However, a minority of people believe he was murdered, possibly by his widow, Courtney Love. Most of these claims can be traced back to private investigator Tom Grant, who has been involved with the case since shortly after Cobain's death. The rumors were given new life in 1997, 3 years after Cobain's death, when rocker Eldon Hoke took time out of promoting his brand to claim that he knew who the murderer was, then suspiciously fell asleep drunk on train tracks with fatal results. Apparently, days before his death, he stated in an interview that Courtney Love offered him $50,000 to kill Cobain, and then mysteriously was found dead on train tracks days later. To me, that is extremely suspicious. However, almost everybody, including the police and Cobain's bandmates, accept the official verdict, although some of his friends and family have expressed doubts. Kurt's body was found in a greenhouse at his home in Seattle on April 8, 1994, by an electrical contractor. Forensics showed that he had died on April 5th from a shotgun wound. Private investigator Tom Grant was hired by Courtney Love to find Cobain after he went missing from a rehab facility. Days after Cobain's body was found, Grant then investigated his death. He came to believe that Cobain was murdered by Love based on factors including heroin levels in Cobain's blood, someone else's handwriting on the suicide note, and the gun itself. The general theory advanced by Tom Grant and others appears to be that Love found out that Cobain was planning on divorcing her, cutting her from his will, and leaving her. And as a result, she allegedly hired a hitman who injected him with heroin and shot him dead. So now I'm going to share some of the evidence that, in my opinion, backs up the murder theory a little bit more. Tests show Cobain had high levels of heroin in his body, and some say that would be so much that Cobain would be unable to hold the gun and pull the trigger. Apparently, there were no fingerprints found anywhere, not on the gun, the door handle, or anything else in the greenhouse. If this had been a suicide, Kurt Cobain's fingerprints should have been found on the evidence, but it appears that it had all been wiped down before his body was found. The police claimed that there was a suicide note found on the scene, but the note itself looked to have been written by two people. The first part had been confirmed as Kurt Cobain's handwriting and didn't mention anything about suicide. It only mentioned about his plans on leaving, divorcing, and taking Love out of his will. Cobain only wrote part of the note, and it appears that somebody added the end references to suicide. The last four lines on the note are less neatly and seem to be written by somebody else's handwriting. Some people believe that Cobain was writing this note, and the heroin finally kicked in, and that's why the last four lines were messy. However, Tom Grant claims that he had found a handwriting practice sheet in Love's handbag, which shows Love has been practicing faking Cobain's handwriting. The gun used was a long-barreled shotgun, which it is suggested that it would be hard to use to shoot oneself in the head. He was found holding the barrel of the gun with his left hand while his right hand was lying next to him. meaning if he had shot himself, he would have had to pull the trigger with his right hand. But some find this hard to believe because Kurt Cobain was left-handed. However, Cobain apparently played guitar right-handed. The bullet casing itself was found on the left side of his body, lying perfectly on a shirt. Given he was found holding the gun upside down with the barrel facing his head and the trigger was on the top of the gun, the injector port for the bullet was on the right side of the gun, meaning the bullet should have been found on the right side of Cobain's body, not on the left side. It is still unclear how it ended up going on the left side of his body. Some people claim that Cobain was holding the gun upright and the trigger was on the bottom whenever he pulled the trigger. And once he pulled the trigger, that's when the gun spun around 180 degrees and landed on him upside down. Now, there's a couple things that to me don't make sense with that scenario. If he had shot himself and the gun was upright, number one is if he had shot himself and pulled the trigger underneath, his hand wouldn't have been found on the right side of his body, in my opinion. His hand should have been underneath that gun. It wouldn't have just slid out and landed as far away as it did. The other thing is, how did the gun mysteriously spin 180 degrees from being upright and spinning down completely, landing on him perfectly still? To me, that makes no sense. If he had shot it that way, it would have at least landed on its side, and I think his hand would have been underneath the gun. It wouldn't have been found in the position it was whenever the police found him. And the last thing that I want to mention is how fast the police announced it was suicide. On average, it takes about 3 weeks in an investigation to find out what actually happened. This usually involves going to all of the people that were close to the victim, in this case Kurt Cobain, and asking questions and finding out if there's anything wrong with him mentally, who had seen him last, and other things like this. That's why it usually takes a few weeks on average, but 2 hours after Kurt Cobain's body was found, the police at the scene announced to the world that it was suicide without doing an investigation. And on top of all of this, there has been some lost evidence over the years. Apparently, the first suicide note had mysteriously disappeared. You can find copies of it online and see the note for yourself, but the actual physical copy of the note is mysteriously gone. Apparently, the other thing that has disappeared is the gun. It is reported that the gun had accidentally been melted down, which to me makes no sense because it is a huge piece of evidence in this case. So even though no fingerprints and nothing else was found on the gun, they can never go back and look at this gun again because this gun has been melted down. It no longer exists. Now, before I looked into Kurt Cobain's death and looked up some of this evidence, I did believe that Kurt Cobain was murdered. However, looking at all of this evidence right now, at least in my opinion from where I stand after doing all this research, is I believe 100% that Kurt Cobain was murdered. So to me, this case should definitely be reopened and it should definitely be looked at a little bit more closely to find out exactly if it was a murder or a suicide. Like I said at the beginning of this video, today marks 25 years since the death of Kurt Cobain. It is very emotional for me because, like I said, he is one of my favorite musicians of all time. So what do you guys think? Do you think Kurt Cobain committed suicide or do you think he was murdered? Or do you agree that they should at least reopen the case? I want to hear what you guys think. Comment down below and let me know. For me, this was a very exciting conspiracy video to do. To do all of the research and put it together for a video was awesome, especially since it was on one of my favorite musicians of all time. I really enjoyed doing this video. So I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, please leave a like, comment down below any other conspiracy videos you guys would like to see me do in the future. I really would like to do a few more this year and try to do a lot more research stuff, videos like this. I do have plans to do a series called Into the Myth, where I look up different myths and urban legends. Expect to see that in the future. Hopefully the first episode will be out this summer. But I am gonna leave this video here. Hope you guys did enjoy. Comment down below what you guys think, if it was a suicide or murder in the case of Kurt Cobain's death. And I will see you guys in the next video. Please take care. Peace.